deck. All right. Let's start with, let's just do the fire signs first. Aries, Leo, and Sag. What are the advices for each sign? Aries, Leo, and Sag. Aries, you got the Eight of Pentacles. There is something that you still need to put a lot of effort and energy in. All right, you're already working on it, and it is going to provide you from continuous manifestation. All right, you are in a manifesting mood. There might be some aspects that you need to focus your energy on as well. All right, this might be even with this Three of Swords, some pain from the past that you need to release, because it might be distracting you from creating the abundance that you want. For others of you, there is definitely a new skill that is going to come to the right horizon for you, which you need to do a little bit more research on and just like focus on creating that, like managing that skill for yourself. But overall, in your YouTube reading, there was also a lot about your manifestation and work. So good job. And I feel like whatever you reap right now, you will sow. So the more you put your heart into it, the more you will receive. Ooh, Leo, Ten of Swords to the Two of Swords. Leo, you've been dragging some kind of ending for a long time. You don't want to look at it, you don't want to face it, you don't want to think about it, but it needs some kind of a completion. You need to surrender to it. If it's someone that has been trying to hurt you, even purposely, or they're doing some stuff behind your back, you've been trying to ignore it, and you need to step up to the game. You need to step up the plate, you need to surrender to it, and you need to accept it. If someone is not messaging you, or they're not contacting you, you need to stop tiptoeing around the issue, and you need to cut it off. You need to cut it off. No answer is also an answer, is what I'm seeing here. Sagittarius, Seven of Wands. So there is something that you need to prove your point on with the Seven of Wands. You are being advised to not give up your faith in the situation, that you still need to work to manifest your goals as well. All right, there are a lot of people that are telling you opposing things, that you need to stop, you know, taking on their opinion. You need to stand on your own and do whatever you feel is right. If someone is trying to tell you what to do, it's like Sagittarius, don't even try, like, don't even try. But I don't know, these are talking a lot about boundaries, and I have the Moon card here. So this might be telling that your mind or might illude you, and that you need to stand firmly on the ground and fight these illusions off. Don't let anyone talk fear into you or deceive you, all right? Knight of Cups, all right, there is someone that's coming in, and you need to prove your point to this individual, all right? You need to speak up loud and clearly about how you feel about the situation with this individual, and do not let this person easily sway you off your feet at all. They need to be pushed back and made clear that how they have been treating you, or how they cross your boundary, all right? So this person is going to come in to sweep you off your feet with some romance, and don't get the knees weak towards this individual. You gotta be strong, all right? Just wanted to pull some more cards for Aries, since we had some here. We got the Wheel of Fortune and the Six of Cups. So again, it's saying that you still have some, it's the same energy. You still have a lot of things that you need to work on from the past, because they can influence your path, and you cannot have the breakthrough that you want in the situation, all right? So we have the Ace of Pentacles for everyone involved here. So there is going to be a new opportunity that comes your way of all of you, which is going to give you a lot of abundance and fairness. This situation will be handled in a fair and just manner. So this is an advice for you, my dear Aries, to handle the situation in a fair manner. And if you have been taking it, well, welcome back. Thank God I stopped the reading on time because the battery fell out. So let's just see what we got going on more. So where I was at was Aries. You need to be fair and just in the situation for everyone involved. And if you have been done an injustice, if there has been an injustice done towards you, it is going to be handled in a fair, just manner. Definitely if it has to do with, you know, work related from the past. All right, there's going to be a breakthrough. Ooh. Leo, advice for Leo, please. Start delegating. Ask others, including me, to help you instead of trying to do everything by yourself. So do not try to ignore your own emotions, your own feelings, or try to sweep this whole situation under the rug, because it's not going to help you. You really need to ask for help and guidance from people that can help you with this situation, all right? Help you to surrender to this betrayal, all right? Sagittarius. Fertility. It is a perfect time for you to start new projects, access new ideas, and give birth to new conditions. So if there is anything on your schedule that you've been wanting to give birth to, this is a perfect time. You got all the odds with you. So, you know, this is also telling me that you should not give up and just keep on fighting, because you are the one that is with the advantage here, all right? So definitely. And we got, for all of you, we got boundaries. Love yourself enough to say no to others demanding on your time and energy. Definitely for Leo and Sagittarius, this is definitely putting up boundaries and standing up for yourself, respecting yourself, and do not let anyone, whether it's love or not, fool you in any kind of way, all right? So let's just see what we have for the air signs. Let's see. Seven of Swords. A lot of you are leaving situations, relationships, or restricting thoughts behind. You might be not wanting to discuss this with anyone and wanting to do this on your own. So let's see, Gemini, what do we have for Gemini, please? What do we have for Gemini? Okay, we've got the Knight of Swords with the Ten of Pentacles. So you're being advised to watch before you speak, all right? Or perhaps even have like a clear cut-through communication about the loyalty within the relationship. There is definitely some kind of commitment that you want to get off the ground, or that you are doubting whether someone is loyal or not. You are ought to watch before you speak and do not jump too fast into conclusions here as well. So there's definitely this drama that is going on within the house environment as well. You really need to listen to your heart and not listen to anyone that can influence you and make you feel like agitated or angry, and then just attack. Could be even attacking people that are just not even, you know, the cause of the problem, just to get your anger out. So there is definitely a warning here with the Knight of Swords to really, you know, think before you speak, all right? And definitely if you are going to accuse someone of their disloyalty, for example. So you might be even wrong, that's what I'm getting. So, and if you do sense that someone is not being loyal to you, you really need to take a step back and watch and take notes. Take a lot of notes. That's what I'm seeing here. Libra. What are the messages for Libra? Knight of Swords and the Three of Pentacles. Some of you are stressed out about there is someone in your environment that does not want to put in the work, and you feel like you've been overdoing, overgiving, and you are stressed out about that. You're not sure how you want to continue with this situation. You feel like this person is asking a lot of energy from you. You are not seeing clearly where this whole project is going or this whole goal of the relationship is going. There, you feel like you're getting kind of like the short end of the stick here, and you need to start thinking about how you can resolve the issue. The Three of Pentacles is all about like dedication and putting in the right work. So instead of like stressing about it, you need to find a new source or a new outlet to get more guidance in how to put the work in with the Three of Pentacles. You are also being guided here. I feel like there is a spirit around you that is trying to comfort you. All right, you might be stressing a lot about work and you needing to, you know, turn off the buttons when you get home, because you will not be productive if you keep on stressing about this work situation. All right, there needs to be like a fresh air in your brain so you can be more productive at work. So try not to stress too much when you get home. Try to leave work whenever you leave work. All right. Aquarius, what do we have for Aquarius, please? We've got the Three of Cups. All right. And the Ace of Cups. I see a lot of love, a lot of celebration, a lot of coming together, all right? And you might be meeting someone, or you've met someone through socializing or through a friend's community, and there is a pouring out of love here. There's definitely, wow, look at that. Queen of Cups is at the bottom of the deck. So there's definitely new love on the horizon here is what I feel, and you both are enjoying a lot of your free time together. There's a lot of enjoyment and fulfillment that both of you are having. There might be even someone in the occasion that is not very happy with the way that you are having fun and being so cuddly in love with someone. So there could be some jealousy around you, or someone that does not like the fact that you might be together with someone that someone already knows, like your ex knows the other person, and they know about the fact that you guys are together, and they can get like very frustrated about that, is what I'm getting. All of you are in a state of, let's see. Funny, the love you have shared is eternal regardless of the situation. So I feel here with you, Gemini, that you might be jumping to conclusion, as I said, and that there is a lot of love that has already been shared, and maybe one of you or someone here on occasion is not appreciating this. And it says that whomever has been sharing a lot of love, it is going to come back to you tenfold. All right, whatever has happened to you, you have to focus on the love that has been shared and not judge or prejudge someone or a situation here. Libra, inner goddess. Awaken the goddess within you through dance, self-care, and appreciating your divinity. So that's what we just talked about. Like, when you get home, instead of stressing about the situation, whatever this is that is urging you to have a lot of time and energy in it, you really need to do other stuff, things that really, where you really take care of yourself, your body, your appearance, and you know, that sometimes it just helps because you just raise your vibration. And definitely this is always reminding me of the Libra energy as well. So definitely it says the Aphrodite, so definitely nice energy. Aquarius, bodies of water, you got a lot of watery energy. This is a lot of love. Spend time near water such as lake, river, or the ocean to recharge your battery. So if you feel depleted within a situation that asks a lot of emotions from you, you really need to go towards the water and just recharge your batteries. There might be a lot of emotional turbulence that comes out because you share a lot of your emotions with this individual. You might be pouring out your heart to someone because you have a lot of trust in them, and that could cause you to, you know, start crying or get very emotional, which is just the regular process of, like, you know, sharing your emotions. So don't worry about that. You guys have the guardian. You and your loved ones are safe and spiritually protected. All right. And for everyone, whatever the situation is that you're in, it is something that is very deep in your heart that you care for a lot. All right. Definitely for you, for all of you, actually, you might be caring a lot about, you know, the progress when it comes to this collaboration or at your workspace. Gemini, you have issues regarding the house situation and the loyalty that you seek or you get from your partner. And here, Aquarius, this is just all love. It's kind of like that love all over the place kind of feeling for you. But very good to see that. So let's see. Who we have here? Capricorn, Taurus, and Virgo. What are the messages for Capricorn, Taurus, and Virgo? What are the advices for Capricorn, Taurus, and Virgo? We got a Queen of Cups for Capricorn. I feel like it's a bingo. Like, we got a Queen of Cups for the Capricorn. And we've got the Strength. So some of you are really holding back from sharing your feelings towards a specific person. All right. You feel intuitively still very much connected to this individual. Could be a water sign, Capricorn. It could be a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, or a Leo individual. But you, if you are having like emotional breakdowns so now and then, it says that you just need to stay strong and find compassion for yourself. Do things that you love to do. Listen to your intuition. Listen to your sixth sense. And don't neglect your own feelings. If you feel that you need to do something, do not always hold yourself back. All right? Listen to that intuition, because your intuition is really guiding you continuously. And I feel like you have been neglecting it so now and then. And with this, the spirit is saying, like, do not neglect that. All right, you have a strong emotional intellect and a strong intuition that you need to work with. Taurus, Eight of Cups, there are some stuff that you need to walk away from, and wow, and the Seven of Wands here. So there's someone that wants to come back around, and you are just not happy with that. You may also understand that you have some codependency issues where you really rely on someone else's approvals, right? Something like that, or the way that someone is thinking about you or feeling about you, and you needing to stop that issue. All right, do not put your own worth into someone else's opinion, because you will lose a lot of your own self-worth. So this is a period for you where you need to work on releasing old baggages, old emotional situations that have been burdening you, and start to, you know, realize your own worth and stand up for yourself. Have faith that your opinion is stronger than what someone else's opinion is saying to about you. All right, and don't let that stifle you in any sense. Just have faith that you are overcoming the obstacle, and you are the one here that is on an advantage here. But in order to win the situation, you do need to release this baggage of codependency. And for some of you, there's definitely some kind of a blockage that you are giving to someone. Like, this person is like, no, you left me, you'll never come back. Like, that's a block for you, is what I'm seeing here. Virgo, Three of Wands. So I feel like there is something, Virgo, that still needs a lot of energy for you to put in. There is still some effort that you need to put in, all right? And it could be due to releasing some past issues as well, like just like Taurus has here. There is something that you feel very sad about that did not come in or did not come into fruition, and you are kind of like stuck with like, oh, that did that. I was so expecting that thing to come in or that person to come in, and that just didn't happen. And you're kind of like losing sight of, you know, your own vision and where you want to go, where you want to be in life. But okay, maybe not that dramatic. Maybe not that dramatic, but it just feels to me that you need to get over this situation, because this is really crying over spilt milk and starting to make plans towards your future. Start visualize things, start to dream about things, and start to, you know, use the law of attraction and to get what you want, and to release this sadness and this sorrow, which is really a blockage. I feel like almost like you are expecting the worst all the time. It's because you've been so, you know, been through that cycle where everything went wrong. Now your problem is you expect the worst. Like you expect like, oh well, I expect that this is just going to go down the drain. That's it. And that's because all of you are still kind of like in this neglected feeling, a kind of like in the depressed kind of energy, all right? And that could be definitely with this lunar eclipse in Capricorn, because it is kind of like this, you know, heavy energy, you know, Saturnus energy can be very heavy, and sometimes it can show you things that you don't want to see. It can show you that, you know, you can be a bit more pessimistic, and that's completely normal. But for you, Virgo, it's kind of like too pessimistic, you know. But it counts for all of you. Some of you are Capricorn, you're neglecting your own emotions, you're neglecting your own feelings and your intuition, and you're not listening to that, which is going to get you a lot in trouble. For you, Taurus, this is definitely a rejection. Like, you are going to reject someone really badly, or you feel very rejected, all right? But it could also be that you need to reject something or someone that has been causing a lot of interference in your life, and you really need to put them in that place. Like, hey, there you go, in that corner. You're not gonna tell me what to do. That's it. So this is definitely that kind of energy. What is going on for Capricorn? Golden opportunity. Wow. So important doors are opening for you right now. Walk through them. You gotta have the strength to walk through those doors. Maybe you have lack of confidence. All right. Maybe a lack of confidence in your intuition, or whether you can handle the job correctly or not. But the golden opportunity is gonna come your way. Look at that. Expect a miracle. There's definitely something that's going to happen, which is going to give you a lot of emotional fulfillment. And at the end, it will give you a lot of power. Taurus. Wow. Divine passion. Be honest with yourself. What is your heart's true desire? So I feel with this that there is something that you really want to work on. There is something that you really truly have faith in, but there could be other people that don't have that faith in you or in whatever you're doing, and you really need to, you know, walk away from things that do not serve you anymore and stand up for yourself and follow your true passion, Taurus. If things do not work, it's probably for your best interest, because there is something that you need to work on. That's perhaps why some things in your life are just not working, is what I'm seeing here. Virgo. Probably purification. Ooh, okay. Independent. Your independence is a foundation for your strength and success. So this is clinging on to the past, and like I said, just being in that misery of like, oh, nothing is going to happen, and like maybe because you have to go at it alone and you were expecting someone to come along with you or help with you, but your independence is going to be the foundation of your strength. Past life. This situation involves your past life memories. So if emotions go up and you feel rejected, depressed, or feeling emotionally out of balance, is because you are dealing with that Capricornish energy of Saturn that is healing the past life karma. That's definitely for all of you involved. It is now your turn to stand up for yourself, to have the courage to do what you want to do emotionally. And for you, Virgo, you really need to, you know, try to heal this past issue that you had. Stop looking at the past as like wasted time and energy. The past is never wasted time and energy, even though a lot of sadness and grief comes from it sometimes, or how do you say that, like regret. But never regret anything that happens in the past. Everything has a lesson. I know it's cheesy, but it's true. Cancer, Pisces, and Scorpio. Cancer. Eight of Cups to the King of Wands. Some of you also have like codependency issues. Could be that you are codependent on someone to always take the lead or take the action, and you need to release that. Some of you are in need to walk away from a fire sign. Could also be. But I feel like this is more saying that you need to because you seem to have like a huge codependency issue on someone else to always take the lead, which needs to be stopped, because that's just not very imbalance. You're also not happy with how someone else is taking the lead. So there could be a lot of control issues here that comes from the past, all right? By the way, why did I even do Pisces first? Let me just start over, because I just don't know why Pisces came first. You should be last. I'm so sorry. Fail. All right, Cancer. I just felt like something was not correct, you know what I mean? Like battery ran out. All right, Judgment with the Two of Pentacles. So there's something that you really need to take a close look at, all right? There is something that you really need to pay attention to the details as well. If you're about to sign a contract, think twice, take 2 weeks before you do that, all right? Because there might be something that you're missing within the contract. So just saying, for others of you, there's definitely some kind of a renewal or a rebirth that is about to happen, that you're not very sure what to think of it, because it can go either way. I feel like there is a lot of balance that is needed from both your ends to make this go successfully, all right? There's just something from the past that's going to come up that's going to keep you doubting a lot. It could be work from the past that comes up, and it makes it like you really want this job that you applied on for like in the past, and it comes to you, and now you have like multiple jobs to juggle, and it's going to be very harsh for you to juggle that. So that's why you need to think twice whether you want to have this extra work on your plate. The money might be good, but you will be exhausted and no time for, you know, more personal life stuff. So be mindful of that. Scorpio. Five of Swords. Someone is feeling betrayed here. Oh, this is nice. This is absolutely gorgeous. Five of Swords with the World card. Finally, that feeling of dragging things or like being used, abused. I'm hearing that song like, sweet dreams are made of these. That's the song that I've heard. that's going like now, it'll loop in my head. But that kind of energy is now completely gone. Like, you want to withdraw yourself from any fighting, any lose-lose situations, anything that has been burdensome, or any mind games, anyone who has been jealous or throwing shades at you, whatever the case is, you're kind of like, shut the door, done. I'm done, over, basta. All right, you're ready to expand, you're ready for your next chapter, you've learned your lesson, you're not gonna go into situations that is not going to pay you off, all right, where you don't evolve spiritually or mentally or even physically, where you don't see any expansion, where you only get like dirt back, you're not gonna do that, all right? So this is absolutely gorgeous energy. No more mind games, no more games at all. You're closing the door and you've done it properly. If you have tried to release that energy of all the toxic energy and the narcissist and whatever, it's the universe is saying like, you did a good job. Just like give yourself a pat on the back and it's good. It's very good. Pisces now. I have a south node in Libra, so I was just like, no, you're not gonna go next. That's just me and my Libra south node sometimes. Pisces, you got the Six of Cups. So nostalgic feelings, thinking about someone from the past. Ooh, King of Pentacles could be an earth sign, Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo, all right? You have a very strong connection to this individual. You are ready to actually put things back in balance here with the Six of Cups, all right? You are very serious. I feel like there is a change in your energy where you are being more reliable. You know what you want. You know how to get it. Financially, you're moving forward. This is as your advice saying that if you're not taking responsibility of your actions, you need to do that and stay consistent. That's what I'm seeing here. The King of Pentacles is a very consistent energy, all right? They put something on their mind and they will go as long as it takes them and they will not budge from it. So it's not a wishy-washy energy. They know what they want, and probably this King of Pentacles knows who they want as their soulmate or someone from the past that they want to go back to. So the past might be knocking on your door, all right? And you might be feeling, there might have been a lot that happened. Ooh, look at that. The Strength over the Devil. When you say the devil is lurking, there's the Strength card, right? So all of you have gone through that Saturnian lesson as well. Funny that you and Capricorn, Taurus, and Virgo are also having that energy. And you all are overcoming any kind of fear that you had. You all are understanding and realizing what your mistakes were, what restricted you in moving things forward. And now you are overcoming that with the strength and your power, but you still need that strength to get the job completed, all right? This is for all of you, because you have here the Judgment cards saying that there is still something from the past that you need to take a second look at before you make the right decision, because if you don't do that, you will at one point fall out of balance, all right? For you, Scorpio, you get the World card here, Devil, and the Strength card. So you have overcome someone's narcissistic behavior and you should be proud of that, like I said. For you, Pisces, I feel like there has been a lot of toxic energies. It could be fear of having a commitment, fear of having like stability that has caused you to, you know, take a step back, and now you need to step up to the plate and, you know, be the man, so to speak, whether you're a woman or not, and be like, okay, well, if I want to be with you, I am going to stay, and that's it. And you all has, wow, I cannot stop. The Hermit is here as well, meaning that you guys have definitely gone through some introspection and some silent treatment here. You've contemplated a lot about this, like I said, about what is restricting you, and now you are moving things. You're overcoming it. You already know that you're overcoming that. I like your energy the most. It just like connects with all the other readings, right? It just really connects. I mean, we're all connected, right? Anyhow, so let's see. Cancer, the arts. Express yourself to creative activities. So maybe if you do take this opportunity, you need to find a more creative way to handle this situation, all right? Scorpio, ooh, you got two cards. You got independent. Your independence is a foundation for your strength and success. So don't cry about losing all your friends or like love, like, well, it depends in what sense. But like if you had some friends that were like being narcissistic towards you and you had to close that door on them, or a lover or whatever, just be grateful and thankful for your independence, because it is going to be your success, all right? I feel like this is so major for you with the Saturn card coming out. You got golden opportunity here as well, that with one closed door, like what? Oh my God, I need to chill, right? One door closes, the other one opens, and the one that opens is a golden opportunity. Like, hell yeah, important doors are opening for you right now. Walk through them. So don't sit too long with whatever has happened. You overcome some kind of a manipulation here, and you should be proud of yourself. Pisces, which cannot wait for his or her turn. Be strong. Wow, look at that. You got twice the strength card. So there's definitely some kind of a evil eye here that is trying to hold you back from whatever you want to put your claws in, right? You are stronger than you think you are, and your strength assures a happy outcome. So be strong, be willing, and be strong and be willing. That's it. Leap of faith. Take a risk and put your heart's true desire into action. So this is for all of you. Take that leap of faith and go at it. You got the force with you, urging you to grow, all right? So I think that was it. And I thank you guys so much. And hopefully soon I'll be back if you like this. It was a long day, so I hope you don't mind. I've been just too high on my energy here, and I just had to get these readings out for you guys as well. So yeah, I see you guys very soon. Ciao.